Hello students, welcome to this class. Today we will discuss something about ecology. Ecology part 2. In which we will discuss something about habitat and niche. What is habitat? Habitat means natural environment or natural home of an organism or animal is known as its habitat. Habitat, animal, living species, human, plants, all of these have special habitat for them. The area or natural environment in which an organism or population means group of organisms live together is known as its habitat. Then habitat is the made up of two types of habitat. One is physical environment, another is biotic environment. In physical environment, it undergoes towards abiotic environment. Abiotic means non-living environment. The physical environment undergoes soil, range of temperature. Temperature means in which temperature the organism living, availability of light, light quality, in which light quality the organism grow and develop its future one, then moisture quantity. All of these undergoes towards the abiotic condition, which is known as its physical environment. Then undergoes biotic environment. We know that bio means living, so living environment of an organism is known as its biotic environment. Biotic environment is divided into two categories: availability of food and presence of predators. Then habitat. In a habitat, an organism must contain food, water, shelter, space for its living and give future ones. All of these are needed, must is necessary. Then a microhabitat. What is microhabitat? The term microhabitat is often used to describe small scale physical requirement. Means little quantity of requirement of a particular organism or a population is known as its microhabitat. Then habitat, example of microhabitat, log rotting in a forest. In a forest ecosystem, when a wood is there, the log rotting microbes are there for rotting of this wood. It is the example of a microhabitat. Then example of animals habitat. In a forest habitat, American crow, Cooper's hawk, northern goshawk, yellow warble, red-eyed vireo, dark-eyed lucan, squirrel, weaver, fox, all organisms or all the creatures are living together. So in a habitat of forest, all the organisms adapt themselves to live in the inside a forest. So the forest is the habitat of this particular organism. Similarly, in undersea habitat, starfish, jellyfish, then cucumber, then sea urchin, all the organisms are living in a deep sea. So for this organism, deep sea is their habitat. Similarly, in Iceland habitat, fish, whale, shark, seal, then different penguins are living. So these are the habitat of this Iceland habitat of the organism. In a desert habitat, the camels, fennec fox, pale fox, then black-throated firefins, all the lizards are living together in a desert ecosystem. So desert are known as their habitat. Then what is niche? Niche means a niche is an organism's role towards the ecosystem. What kind of organism's job towards the ecosystem is known as their niche? It includes what it eats, where it lives, and what it does is known as its niche. Type of niche. In the following category, the type of niche, two type of niche are seen. One is fundamental niche and second is realized niche. in fundamental niche can be defined as the range of environmental condition in which each of the species survive. In a particular environment, which species is living is known as its fundamental niche, wherein realized niche can be termed as the range of environmental condition in which a species is really found. In a particular environmental condition, which species is seen, actually seen, is known as its realized niche. Then examples of fundamental and realized niche. For example, a raccoon is an insect. They naturally live in forest and eats the insects, fruits and other small creatures is known as its fundamental niche. Then raccoon, the encroachment by humans change their habitat to an urban environment and they start to live off our trash and other waste material is known as its niche. Other examples of niche are for a weaver, cutting down trees, building a dam to flood an area to make a pond, building a lodge to live in, raising a family of weaver, chewing the bark and wood, means outer layer of the plant, all are the niche of or activity of a weaver, so known as niche of weaver. Similarly, red-tailed hawk and owl, the birds have the prey. Prey means it eating other dead body and other organisms. So it lives in forest and edge of the field. It mice and other rodent and nest in the tree are the nature of this organism or these birds. So they are declared the niche of these birds. Then no two species can occupy the exact or same niche, meaning the two species cannot occupy the same niche because no two species are exact in same thing. They are differ their character, their activity, their habitat. So no two species occupy the exact niche or exact job in a particular ecosystem. If they do or try to, one will do better and other will change their activity or become extinct. Extinct means totally disappear. If they act like other organism, one organism act like other organism, they totally disappear from this ecosystem. Then definition of adaptation. Adaptation means adjustment or change in the behavior, physiology and structure of an organism is known as its adaptation, to become more suited towards environment. According to environment, adjust one organism is known as its adaptation. It is derived from a Latin word adapter, which means to fit. Then plant adaptation. Plants have adaptation to help them live and grow in different areas. This adaptation might make it very difficult for the plant to survive in a different place. If we take one plant and place it another area or another surrounding, it is different to grow to the plant. So adaptation is required to adjust the plant within the surrounding. This explains why certain plants are found in one area but not in other area. For example, you would not see a cactus tree in Arctic region. Cactus is only seen in the desert region because in desert sandy soil are there and cactus is adjust that sandy soil. So plant adapted, the cactus plant adapted towards the desert soil. Then why do plants adapt? Spike or thorn? It is the characteristic of spikes and thorn are the characteristic of a desert plant. Then why do plants adapt? brightly colored fruit and vegetable attract the animals to eat. Similarly, colorful petals attract the birds and insects for pollination. It is the adaptation towards the plant. Then types of adaptation. There are two types of adaptation are found. One is structural adaptation. Second one is behavioral adaptations. In structural adaptation are the way something is built or made. And behavioral adaptation are the way something acts naturally or by insect, with the help of insect. Then structural adaptation, adaptation to get food. Leaves and stems absorb energy from the soil, then accept water from the root and convert the carbon dioxide towards glucose level food is known as its adaptation. Then in behavioral adaptation, adaptation to get food, plants learn or grow towards the sun. Roots grow down into the soil and vines climb up the trees to catch sunlight. It's the adaptation of the plant. Then structural adaptation, adaptation to get water and nutrients. The roots work is to soak the water and nutrient from the soil and give it to the leaves. It is the adaptation of the root towards the soil. Similarly, in behavioral adaptation, in desert, flowers can stay in dormant for months long. Only when rain coming, the life of the flower start. It is the behavioral adaptation of the desert plant. Then plant adaptations for different biomass. It is the biomass. Biomass means different areas in which the plants grow, known as its biomass. For desert adaptation, small leaves or spines on desert plants conserve water. A thick waxy skin is seen and which has the water holding capacity. The roots near the soil surface suck up rainwater quickly before it evaporates. All the qualities are present in the desert adaptation. Grassland adaptation. In a grassland ecosystem, deep roots help the plants for survival and narrow leaves lose less water than broad leaves. So, narrow leaves are present in grassland ecosystem and the stem is flexible. In water adaptation plant, flexible stems move with water current and floating seeds spread of springs. So, this type of adapted plants are seen in water. For desert plant, some plants called succulent, which stores water for long time, and some plants have no leaves or small seasonal leaves because small leaves can control the transpiration. The lack of leaves help reduce water losing capacity for photosynthesis also. So, leafless plants conduct photosynthesis in their green stems. Long root systems spread out wide or go into deep ground to absorb water. Then, temperate grassland plant adaptation. During a fire, while above ground portion of grasses may perish, the root portion survive to sprout again. Some roots are remain inert. Or after some times, the root grow into a plant. Similarly, the shrubs readily resprout after fire. Roots are extend deep into the ground to absorb as much as moisture as they can. An extensive root system prevent grazing animals from pulling roots out of the ground. So, all these characters are for temperate grassland plant adaptation. Then tiga plant adaptation. Many trees are evergreen. Evergreen means all time greenery are seen at that ecosystem so that plants can photosynthesize right away when temperatures rise. Many trees have needle-like leaves which shape loses the less water and sheds snow. Snows are present all the tree, or snow cover all the tree leaves. So waxy coating on the needle prevent the evaporation of water. Needles are dark in color and more solar heat to be absorbed. Many trees of Tiga plant adaptation are branches that droop downwards and help the shed excess snow to keep the branches from breaking. So all about the Tiga plant adaptation. Then plant adaptation in water. How plants are adapted in water? Underwater leaves and stems are flexible to move with water current. Some plants have air space in their stems to help hold the plant up in the water. Submerged means half floating plants are lack strong water transport system. Instead, water, nutrients and dissolved gases are absorbed through the leaves directly from the water. And rooted plant means underground rooted plants are reduced or absent. Their roots only needed for anchorage, not for absorption of nutrients and water, because it remain inside the water. Then tropical rainforest plant adaptation means all time rainy forest are the drip tips of waxy surface allow the water to run off and discourage growth of bacteria and fungi. Some plants climb on other plant to reach the sunlight, and some plants grow on other plants to reach the sunlight and water. Flowers on the forest floor and designed to lure animal pollination, since there is a relatively no wind in that forest, on the forest floor to add the pollination. This is all about the adaptation, the habitat and needs. And I will continue the ecology part in next class. Thank you.